And that's clearly what it is. Former Senator Nancy Schaefer shot to death with husband. She'd been calling us in the last few months wanting to get on. I've been so busy I hadn't called her back. And some of her associates, she was the head of the Eagle Forum, a prominent group nationwide, but head of it in Georgia. She got shot in the back, her husband in the chest. You know, that's not how you commit suicide. But the media said, oh, well, her husband had cancer and it was a suicide pact. Her daughter says that's not true. But get her daughter on. I know it's hard for her. She's grieving right now. This is very suspicious. We have her home number. Call it. I bet she's there. I bet her daughter's there right now. It's her daughter that found their dead bodies. She had been working on child trafficking rings. She talked about that on air last year when she was on with us, how the CPS has quotas, especially for blonde-haired, blue-eyed kids. They'll say we want a dark-haired, blue-eyed three-year-old, and they go into the daycares everywhere looking for excuses. They have bounties. You can't make this stuff up, folks. It's just, and she's dead. And then they clearly killed her. I interview so many people that get killed. It's like, because if you have first-hand knowledge of this stuff, you better get it all out on the plate and fast. It's like the D.C. madam. We had her on, and I said, you will not commit suicide, correct? She said, I will not commit suicide. Then the media said, oh, she committed suicide. Then we call her landlord at her condo she'd known for over a decade. She said men were following her, that they might kill her, that she was going to have to go to prison, that she was moving her stuff to her mother's house, and then they killed her. Then he sent me her handwriting from her lease. Was not anything like. Every letter was different, her supposed suicide letter. God almighty, folks. I mean, you can come on the air and say, I'm not going to kill myself. Well, you can go on the air and say, I'm not going to kill myself, and then they kill you. They'll even shoot you twice in the back of the head like they did Gary Webb and say it was a suicide. Then they had his supposed friend, who he'd actually criticized in newspapers as not his friend, come out and say, oh, I'm his friend. It's quite normal to shoot yourself twice in the head. I'll say it again. If God forbid that happens to me, I did not kill myself. It is a lie. 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 All right, I'm going to shut up. We're not playing games here. We got a lot of stuff to cover. This ties in with the Moscow blast. All this hype about women with breast implants, how they now want to x-ray you to fly and have mobile x-ray trucks, powerful chest x-rays, because the terrorists can have a surgeon put it into their breast. And now they're saying their faces were undamaged. It may be a breast bomb. Terrorists could use explosives and breast implants. The body scanners. Now we played the footage of Homeland Security videos with the big mobile 18-wheelers that are going to naked body scan you. He has introduced legislation. It's got a good chance of passing if you get behind it. Representative Phil Hart, Idaho House District 3, Seat B. He is a businessman. He owns and operates Alpine Engineering in Hayden. He is a licensed civil and structural engineer in 11 states. And he's the author of Constitutional Income, Do You Have Any? We'll give you a website and information, phone number to get that before he leaves us. And I hadn't talked to him yet. I just said, get him on the show. And I was honored to find out. He found out a lot about this stuff here on this show. Good to have you here, Representative.
Thanks, Alex, for having me on.
So tell us about yourself, your awakening, why you're doing this, and how we can help you start a movement at the state level to say no to the child porn law violating naked body scanners.
My parents got me started in politics when I was 8 years old, and I was going door to door for Barry Goldwater, passing out leaflets and stuffing things in people's door. And they were really quite the activists. We had a mimeograph machine in our house, and we were constantly going to meetings and writing our own literature and passing it out. And I guess it just carried over. And as I got to become an adult, you know, and you see what's going on around the world, and it's hard to sit still. I mean, we're really in a fight for the republic. And I think it's going to take each one of us, assuming that the republic depends on what we do to save our republic. And so I'm busy at the state level, working in the Idaho legislature, trying to do pass legislation that's going to protect our liberties.
Well, that's awesome. What got you fired up against this naked body scanners in your state?
Well, I've seen a couple of them as I've flown around the country, but I also listen to your show quite a bit, Alex, and I, you know, through your show, I've been kind of keeping apprised of what's going on, and I thought, you know, there isn't any reason why we can't put some sideboards on the use of these things at the state level. And so what I did is I took some legislation that was drafted by Congressman Jason Chavez of Utah, and I changed it a little bit and made it apply more to the state level. His bill has gotten through the House of Representatives back in Washington, D.C. It's currently stalled in the Senate. So I came up with basically a state version of that bill and made it apply to state facilities and public facilities, and we're running with it at the state level. And we got it out of the House of Representatives about 2 weeks ago, and now my bill is stalled in the Senate at the moment.
Well, we need to attack at every level peacefully through the legislative process, as you know. We need to put pressure on the U.S. Senate. I mean, in every poll, upwards of 90% are against these naked body scanners. And we need to go to the state level as well and try in every state to say no, so it'll set a precedent. How do we help you get this done in the state of Idaho?
Well, we've got a few days left in our session, and it's possible that we could still get this done if it became a high priority. So for those of your listeners who are from Idaho or really from anywhere, call into the state legislature. Direct your call to the Senate. Ask them to hear this bill. It's House Bill 573. But, you know, Alex, if I don't get it done this year, I've got the bill drafted. The bugs have been worked out of it. I'll just introduce it right at the very beginning of next year, and I think it'll go next year.
Well, you've got a lot of public support, don't you?
I do, yes. I haven't had any negative feedback on this from the public. And when people find out I'm working on it, they encourage me to, you know, keep pushing forward.
I've read over the law, but I mean, explain how these scanners are unconstitutional, a violation of rights, and the type of language and attack you're using to point out that these things need to be barred.
Tough legal issue. I mean, we're at the state level. We have plenty of authority to limit the use of these things in a state facility. But you know, the big issue is with airports, and TSA is operating at the airports. You know, I did a little research and found out that our airports in Idaho are on state of Idaho real estate. In other words, we haven't ceded that ground to the federal government like you do at some military bases. So we do have jurisdiction to some degree, but typically, the federal law trumps the state law, unless we're talking about the police power of the state, which may kick in if we can prove that these things are unhealthy for people who are exposed to them. Because we have certainly a duty at the state level to protect the health and medical condition of our citizens. And so that's where I hope we can make a good argument that would allow us to regulate these in our airports here in the state of Idaho.
Well, I've even seen New York Times articles quoting top scientists saying these millimeter waves do break up human DNA. And now they're saying, hey, we're not just going to naked body scan you. We want x-rays in there, high powered, to see if you've got explosives in your breast. They're now at airports all over the Western world. I see it on the news. They grab the woman's breast and squeeze and go in a circle. And Paul Watson, a webmaster in England, his girlfriend says it's very painful. And men grab her breasts, women grab her breasts, they grab men's genitals. I mean, this is clearly conditioning. And now Homeland Security, I don't know if you've seen it, but guys, pull it up. They have these mobile trucks that are 18-wheeler backs. They're going to put at sports stadiums, checkpoints. This is on the video. And they march you in, and they say they're going to have scanners, brain scanners. I mean, this is insane.
Well, one of the arguments that we can make for that particular aspect of this is that the states have jurisdiction over the things that have traditionally been in the power of the states. And the federal government can't just walk into some new area of our economy or our society and claim that they've got the jurisdiction. And so this is something the feds have never done before. They're going to be doing it in the states on state real estate, if you will. And, you know, they don't have jurisdiction. But if we don't push back, they'll just assume they do have the jurisdiction and they'll just go ahead and do whatever they want.
Well, they know what they're doing. And then meanwhile, all these Homeland Security officials leave Homeland Security. In Homeland Security, they make the purchase orders, send it to Congress. They get it. Then they leave Congress or they leave Homeland Security. And then they revolving door into the corporations getting millions of dollars. I mean, this is just openly illegal.
That's right, and I'm sure you know that Chertoff, former director of Homeland Security, is now a lobbyist representing some of the companies that make these scanners.
And he says that's fine because he believes in it. And that's like in Kentucky, the head of elections is now running for Senate against Rand Paul, and they've ruled he can run his own election. I mean, no state has ever allowed that. That's always been illegal. This is just, it's amazing.
One thing we need to do is research what conditions gave birth to the Fourth Amendment, the protection against unreasonable search and seizures. And I understand it was a Townsend Act that the king or the British were promoting, where they would go into people's houses and search for the stamp of the king on all.